how to make your dreams possible once and for all. The other day I was reading about these two boys. One was a real small boy and one was a big boy, and they're out messing around, just playing around like boys do on this thick icy pond when the big boy fell through this thick icy pond and couldn't make his way back up through the hole. He was pounding on the ice but couldn't find the hole to make himself back up. And a few minutes later, when the paramedics did arrive, they found, much to their shock, that the older big boy was laying on the side of the pond. And after they revived him back to life, they looked around and said, how is it possible? How did this guy even get out of this thick icy pond? And there was this neighbor there who had heard the commotion, came over to try to help, told the paramedics to look over at the little boy. And the paramedics were scratching their head like, how is that even possible that this little boy could help this big boy out of this big, thick, icy pond? How is that possible? And the neighbor said, because nobody was here to tell the young man that it was impossible. Who's told you that your dream's impossible? What is possible for you? There's so many things that are possible for you. And listen, I'm here today to help you. And some of you know me as the founder of World Class Couples Academy, where we help singles find the love of their life and marriages become a masterpiece. And some of you know me as the director of an organization at the University of Illinois. But maybe what you didn't know is I'm the founder of Designing Champions Coaching, because I love to help people reach their potential, to maximize their potential, businesses and organizations and people, so that they can experience all the success and significance that comes with getting to the top and serving other people. And today I want to help you with four ways to turn your particular, your specific dream into not just possible or probable, but a reality. You have to have these four things. One is this: commit. Listen, you know this. It's common sense, but not all common sense is common practice. You have to go for it. You have to go all in. Too many people have backup plans after backup plans after backup plans backing their backup plans. And so many people get stuck because they're depending on their backup plans, because they're afraid that they might fail. They're afraid that they might succeed. They have all these self-doubts. But listen, you have the capacity to succeed in your life. You do have the capacity. I just want to be a messenger of hope and light today, because you have the capacity to succeed at life. You have the capacity to achieve your dreams. You know, you've heard that old story about burning their boats, where that whole Navy fleet, or the boat fleet, went to this island to get the treasure, and they sent spies on the land to find out who all the army was, and they realized that they were far outnumbered. There's no way they're going to be able to get this treasure. So the spies came back, and what they came back to was their army. The captain on the beach had burned their boats. They were going up in flames, and the spies and other people in the army who had wandered off come back and said, what the heck are you doing? You can't burn our boats. That's our way out of here. We're going to die. And the captain said, that's the exact mentality that I was afraid that you would have. And if we went into battle knowing that we could always escape and have a backup plan after a backup plan after a backup plan, we would never defeat the enemy. We would never be victorious. We would never accomplish our dream. And we would never freaking get the treasure that we came all the way across the Pacific Ocean to get. Now, we got to commit to going all in, and we're going to get it or we're going to die. And you got to have that kind of mentality, is to burn the boats. Every single day, you got to wake up and say, I'm committed today. I'm going after my dream today. To write down your goals. I do this every day. I write down my goals every single day, just to get it in my heart, to get it in my mentality. And at this point, some of my clients say, am I going to sacrifice work-life balance? Listen, work-life balance. Here's a memo. Here's a wake-up call. It's an illusion. It's an illusion. What you want for is work-life integration, where your life loves your work, your work loves your life, your wife loves your work, your husband loves your work. It's just a combination, and you work at it till it's just a joy for everybody. And if you're not committed, you're not going to make it happen. And the number one thing to get you to commit is to be hungry, is to go after it, to know that you have this burning desire in your heart to say, I'm going to accomplish this dream. I am committed. I have hunger, and because without hunger, without passion for this, you are not going to be fully committed. And you have to want your dream, whatever your particular dream is, far more, and it must be greater than watching Netflix or going out on Saturday night. I mean, that's just the way it is. You have to want it more than that. So number one is to commit. Number two is to get in a state of certainty. Certainty. Most people are always doubting themselves and in this land between I can do it and I can't do it. I think I can do it, or it may not happen, or what if, or what if. The number one killer of dreams, and at least where I coach people, is there's so many self-doubts, so many limiting stories in their minds. So you got to get yourself into a state of certainty. You generate it from within. If you look at successful people in any industry, in any sport, and in any home, you just watch them, just observe them, I guarantee you they're in a state, their physical state is a state of certainty, like, I can do it. Of course I can do it. I'm meant to do this. I'm supposed to do this. So the challenge is, every single day, is to starve your doubts. Whenever you get a doubt, starve it. Don't feed it. By feeding it, you just give it more thought. Don't allow yourself to think or ruminate over it, or you're going to put yourself in a state of doubt. It's a killer of your dreams. It's a killer of your momentum. You'll start, stop, and you'll never accomplish it. And people will say, see, I told you so. Instead of, so starve your doubts and feed your faith. And another thing you can do is speak differently to yourself. Say things like, man, I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it. My future is bright, and I am certain that I'm going to make it. I'm gonna get there. If I don't get there, I'm not going to be able to serve people. I want to serve people. I want to help people. I want to fulfill my calling. And listen, if you're religious, you can quote the Bible. It says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Or we are more than conquerors. That God is doing a good work in you, is bringing out greatness in you. So that's another thing. You talk to yourself. You can also use your body. I mean, you have a body. We just assume that it's there, but we can use it to drive our thoughts, because it's the fastest thing that will drive your brain. Most people, when they think about their dream, they get stuck. They get stuck in their head, and they start worrying, and they have analysis paralysis, and get stuck, which leads to excuses and reasons instead of results, and you don't accomplish what will bring you ultimately fulfillment. So instead of doing that, instead of analysis paralysis or getting stuck in your head, use your body to generate certainty and strength. Well, how do you do that, Aaron? Well, I don't know. There's a thousand ways. I'll give you a few. One is you could run around the block and say, yeah, I mean, just get the blood flowing. Feel good. Another thing you could do is take a freezing ice cold bath to blow up the nerves and get the blood flowing and oxygen flowing throughout your body, the nitric oxide flowing. You could speak certainty out loud, like, man, I am certain I'm going to make this happen. I'm certain that I'm going to speak to the love of my life. I'm certain that I got a great marriage. I'm certain that I'm going to fill my bank account. You have to get yourself into a state of certainty. Another way to do it is interrupt your breathing patterns. Just in through your nose, get that nitric oxide, which is in the back of your nose, out through your gut. When you're in a state of doubt, watch your body language. You're slumped over. You're kind of depressed. You're not breathing. I talked to a young man the other day. He wasn't breathing like the whole conversation. Was just... And he was in doubt. He was completely in doubt. So all we had to do is get him up, get some inhale, get some oxygen flowing throughout your body. Another thing you can do besides running around the block, taking that ice cold bath, breathing, interrupting your breathing patterns, is focus on only the emotions that make you feel empowered or feel good, because this will cause you to take better actions and make better decisions. You get better decisions, you have better actions, you get better results. This isn't hoping for your dream to come true. It's not wishing or wanting your dream to come true or hoping for the best. It's shifting your state, your body, into a state of certainty. So one is commit, burn your boats, go all in. Don't look back. Two is you get yourself in a state of certainty, and you got to do this often, because you've trained yourself to doubt. You've allowed yourself to feed your doubts rather than your faith and belief in what can happen. Three is condition your life. Condition your dream. Condition your dreams in an advantageous way. What do I mean by that? Well, 90% of your life is habit or routine. That's a natural reflex. That's all habit means, is you naturally react and reflect on your life. You wake up and your brain just tells you to go brush your teeth or use the bathroom and get a drink of water, or whatever your habits are, 90%. Oh, there might be a little variation from day to day, but you're doing the same thing, arriving at work the same way, coming home in the same part of the garage. And we become, that's why we call creatures of habit. And one of the greatest reasons why we are defeated in our dreams is because we look at our routines and habits, which are our lives, and then we try to incorporate something on the outside, which we call our dream. And we see our dream and our everyday lives and tasks and routines as kind of competitive rather than integrating the two. And if you don't change your routines, you won't make your dream a reality. So what you have to do is look at your routines, look at your habits, your 90% of your life, and say, how can I incorporate my dream into my, not just routines, my daily habits, my daily routines? And when you change your routines, you will change your life. It's the only way to achieve your dreams is to get into something routine, because it creates momentum. To look at your routines and to exchange the bad ones for the good ones, for the dream killers, put in dream successors, whatever you want to call it. And most of your routines, if I were to come over to your house and just watch you and walk around with you every day, is I would see routines and habits all about survival. I got to get the kids ready. I got to do this. I got to do that. And all of that's about surviving. At least it's part of our story that we've told us. And so our brain goes into survival mode, and dreams are only accomplished in thriving mode. And you have to think in terms of thriving and incorporate thriving routines into your life. And there's all kinds. You can watch my other videos to find some of those things. And at this point, you might be saying, Aaron, I've tried everything to accomplish my dream. There's no way. Even if I commit and have certainty and condition start some of my routines, I've already tried everything. And I'm thinking, really? You've tried everything under the sun? Okay, Aaron, I've tried thousands of things. Name the thousands of things for me, I tell the clients. And so, Aaron, I've tried hundreds. Okay, I'm still waiting for you to name hundreds. Name for me 10. What? Okay, fine. I've tried 3 or 4 or 5 things over and over again, and I'm expecting different results. And I say, that's what Einstein called insanity. Doing the same thing over and over and over again, expecting different results. Listen, we all have dreams in our heart. Every human being that you see has dreams in your heart. The people who get their dreams, the people who achieve their dreams and experience the fulfillment, they know their calling is calling them to do, so they can be a bearer and server of the light to other people and humanity, and to live the life that's the best life for themselves. They've got to, you know, condition their routines to believe in themselves, to condition their mentality and rewire their brain with new thoughts, with new actions, and to try other things besides those 2 or 3 or 4 other things, and keep trying different things until you hit on something, and stay consistent with it. Another thing you can do is to, you know, condition your story that you tell yourself over and over and over again. Of we have this story of why we're not achieving, and we say, I knew that can't happen, or this is going to come up, or I don't have the money, or only those who make money can make money, or only those who have money can make money, or whatever your story is. But listen, today I just want to encourage you that you can break free. It won't all happen overnight, but progress happens day by day by day through the conditioning, through the routines, to recondition your thoughts to think, I'm going to expect things to happen. I'm not just going to hope for things to happen anymore. I'm not even going to just wish or want things to happen. I'm not even going to just write it down. I'm going to live in a state of certainty because I've committed to this. I'm going to condition my thoughts to say, I'm expecting this dream to become a reality in my life. I'm expecting the greatness to come out of me, because I believe this, that God is doing a great work in you, and that it's just trying to unfold this. We've been raised in different ways where we've capped it out. Another thing you can think of in terms of conditioning is, failure is not all bad. Listen, don't be afraid of failure. When you fail, you fall down, you get back up, and you fail again, then you get back up. I think it was Churchill or someone said, success is going from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. Say, wow, I failed again. And just the way I have enthusiasm about it, because I fail at things, is I simply say, hey man, this just made me stronger and preparing me for what's ahead. Otherwise, I would not be able to fulfill my dream that's ahead if I hadn't gone through this failure. It would have been a colossal fail if I hadn't gone through this. So that's the third thing, is to condition your mind, condition your heart, condition your expectations. And the fourth thing in order to turn your dreams from possible to probability to reality is community. So commit, certainty, condition, community. And by community, I mean just take audit. Audit those around you. Look around you in your life. Are they supporting you in your dream? Are they cheering you on in your dream? Are they just a big pain in the butt? Are they challenging you? Because listen, you know this. You've heard me say this a million times. Jim Rohn said this. Hundreds of thousands of people are saying this. You become the average of the five people that you surround yourself with the most. So take an inventory. Audit the people in your life. Listen, you didn't always pick the people in your life. You didn't pick your parents. They didn't pick you. You just showed up, and maybe you had parents who were like most parents who said, don't talk to strangers. Don't talk to strangers. Or be careful, little Johnny. Be careful, little Susie or Sally. Or turn off the lights or shut the door. And these just little mottos and hundreds of more created a narrative in our mind and in our DNA. Something called epigenetics and all of that stuff, where we just now subconsciously live these narratives out. Like, okay, don't talk to strangers. Okay, so now we grow up and we're afraid to talk to strangers. We're afraid to go up to people as if they're gonna bite us, as if they're gonna hurt us. So I say, guess where the love of your life is? Stranger. Guess where the money is? Strangers. Guess who your next clients are? Strangers. Guess who you can serve? Strangers. Guess who your next best friend is? Strangers. Guess who somebody is you can have compassion on? Stranger. Guess the next person you can have a great big laugh with? Stranger. Guess the person who can bring out the potential in you? A stranger. You gotta talk to strangers, but we're pounded from right motives that lead to disastrous results, that we don't talk to strangers. We put walls up, which also put walls around love and opportunities in our life. Or, you know, take be careful, be careful, be careful. So now when it comes to our dream, we think, oh my gosh, I gotta be careful. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, what if I fail? Oh, I can't take these risks. Don't throw caution to the wind. And these people are all feeding us these ideas, and it creates doubt and uncertainty, and we then have lack of commitment, and we condition ourselves the wrong way because the community has been spoken into our lives this way. We've grown up with this. You got to recondition, recommit, re-energize with different kinds of certainty. Or turn off the lights, turn off the lights, turn off the lights. And that puts in our mindset scarcity. Like, oh my gosh, there's only so much electricity. Oh my gosh, there's only so much money. I can't reproduce money, or I can't go make more money to have the lights on, and all kinds of things. Just a scarcity mindset gets in us instead of an abundant mindset where I can say, hey man, I can create more. Hey man, I can give more. Hey man, there's always more to go around for people, and surround myself with people of an abundance mindset. We create more for other people, and these products help people, and then they're inspired and they create more, and more humans are helped in humanity. So you gotta shift out of some of these mindsets. Another thing you can do in terms of community and associations and picking the right people now that you've grown up is stop watching the news. Unless it changes, stop watching the stinking news. It pollutes your mind. It's pretty much pollutes it with negativity and alarmist messages. Oh no, the world is falling apart. Oh my gosh, what are we gonna do? All the plans, everybody run for the hills. You know, and so people pay for this and tune in. Oh my gosh, Johnny, did you see this? Or hey, blah, 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 blah. Meanwhile, there's a select few people who are achieving their dreams, while everybody else is freaking out and giving in to the propaganda with this truth, but twisted to make us have a disproportionate view of the world. I mean, when's the last time you turned on the news and you saw for an hour straight all the airplanes flying safely and landing safely? You don't. What you see is the one that has a little bit of electronic failure and it almost had to call in for help. Didn't crash, nothing like that, but it's like, oh my gosh, did you see this plane? Ah! Instead of, wow, look at the people walking the elderly across the street. Wow, look at the people helping the people in the nursing home. Wow, look at the people helping AIDS victims. Wow, look at the people really crushing it today with their dreams. We don't see any of that stuff, so we have this disproportionate view of reality. So what you want to do is you want to associate with people who always believe that things are getting better on Earth in many, many different ways. And when there's problems, they say, let's solve those problems. And the last thing you want to do with community is pick new people, the news, and all that. But don't tolerate cynics and don't tolerate doubters in your life, because you get exactly what you tolerate. And if you tolerate doubters and cynics, you'll become a cynic and you'll have all kinds of doubts in your minds, and that will keep you stuck. You'll never achieve your dreams at the level that you want to achieve them at. Listen, those are the four ways that you can move your life into achieving your dreams from possibility to a probability to turning them into a reality. When people say it's impossible, I just kind of chuckle and say, that's your opinion, man. Impossibility is absolutely, is simply an opinion, because it's always impossible until somebody does it. I don't know if it's 70-30, 90-10, 80-20, but it's usually 80-90% mentality to achieve your dreams and 10-20% skill set, or honing in on your skills and abilities. And your skill set, you can always learn and develop. Just think about your dream and say, I'm going after it. And that's why I hammered in on some of the mentality today, is commit, have a level of certainty, generate your certainty. Condition your mind, condition your language, surround yourself with the right people in the community, and you'll develop the skill set as you go along, because you have this burning desire, you have this hunger, you're going for it, you're all in, you burned your boats, so you have to do this now. And when you have to do it, you're going to do it. That's why immigrants are so successful, because they have to do it. They got to do it. And that's the state that you want to put yourself in, is a state of certainty. Like, I'm going all in. I'm going to do it. Is it your dream or is it not your dream? And if it's your dream, here's what you need to know. You have a unique advantage to accomplish your personal and particular and specific dream. And here's why. The unique advantage is you. You are the possibility in every impossibility. So next time you see the impossibility come up for your dream, you say, I am the possibility in that impossibility. I am the possibility in that impossibility. I am the possibility today in all of my impossibilities that people are trying to project onto me today and tomorrow. And in that, you will break through and achieve dream after dream after dream. I wish you all the best.